All right, Ryan, what's on your radar?
Well, so last week, the White House rolled out a new anti-corruption policy, saying that the battle against global corruption is a core national security issue. They wrote in a new memo, anonymous shell companies, opaque financial systems, and professional service providers enable the movement of laundering of illicit wealth, including in the United States and other rule of law-based democracies. Corruption threatens United States national security, economic equity, global anti-poverty and development efforts, and democracy itself. Okay, set aside the irony that Joe Biden represented Delaware starting in 1972. That state is home to more tax dodgers, money launderers, and shell companies than you can even begin to imagine. But the memo isn't wrong. Corruption erodes people's faith in their government, whether that's here in Washington or abroad in Kabul. And it creates an opening for strongmen or fanatical groups like the Taliban to exploit legitimate popular frustration. The problem for the administration is that one man's corruption is another man's reasonable way of doing business. And the White House will have a hard time being taken seriously if it doesn't begin to take its own conflicts of interest seriously. This, after all, is a State Department run by Antony Blinken, who left government service to start a consulting firm, West Exec Advisors, explicitly to leverage the connections he and other former administration officials had won through their public service. They set it up as a shell company with little transparency into clients, but enough have been revealed to understand the ridiculous depth of the conflicts of interest. Clients include Blackstone, which has its hands everywhere, SoftBank, which does extensive business with Saudi Arabia, Boeing, Facebook, etc., etc. Last summer, the American Prospect published a great look at the way Biden's foreign policy advisors had profited